Hello children, hope everyone is doing good. Okay, so children, have you ever observed like when you are running, when you are sitting, when you are doing some function, some movement in your body, how is that possible that you are able to move the body parts separately? Whenever you want, you are able to move it. So have you observed that? Okay, then also when you touch your hand, when you touch your hand, when you touch your head, how you will feel that area? It will be hard and bony, right? So even you can touch and see each part of your hand, okay? And press little bit and just observe, like how do you feel? How do you feel? Like there will be certain bony like structures inside your body that will help you to give the movement of your body, and the it gives a support to your body. So today in this class we will learn about the body movements. Okay, so that is lesson number 8, body movements. So for the movement to happen, our body has skeletal and muscular system. So now skeletal system is a system, is a framework of the bones in our body. Okay, so it is a framework, that means a kind of a photo frame. If you have a photo frame, so that gives a support to your photo, right? That frame. So here the bones give the support to our body, muscles and all the organs. Okay, so that is why we call it as a framework of the bones, framework of our body. Then skeletal system, the functions of the skeletal system is, it gives, along with the muscular system, it gives the proper support to our body and the posture to our body, that we can stand erect, we can sit, we can bend. So all this is because of the skeletal and muscular system working together. Skeletal systems also, in some cases, the bones, the long bones especially. There are various kinds of bones, children, like long bones, flat bones, short bones, irregular bones. In the long bones, there is a soft tissue, okay, tissue which is called as a marrow. Its function is to produce the red blood cells, the blood cells in our body, okay. So that means the skeletal system, you can also say it helps in the production of the red blood cells. Then it also functions like, it also protects the internal organs of our body. So moving forward, we'll learn which are the internal organs the bone will protect. Okay. So these are the functions of the skeletal system, children. Now skeletal system is divided into two parts. Axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Okay, so axial skeleton consists of skull, ribcage and backbone, while appendicular skeleton consists of four limbs. These are our four limbs, and our legs are the hind limbs. Then the girdles. The girdles are nothing but big bones, irregular or okay, you can say bones, which help in joining the appendicular skeletal system, that is the four limbs and hind limbs, to the axial skeletal system. Okay, this girdles, pectoral and pelvic girdle. Pectoral is the pectoral girdle consists of the shoulder blade, that is the shoulder bone and the collar bone. So it helps these four limbs to join with the axial skeleton. Okay. So now first let us learn about the skull. So what is skull, children? You must have all seen the skull as an image, correct? So skull is a this part, the whole face or the head part, we will call it as a skull. So skull consists of total 22 bones. And I believe you know how many bones does an adult human possess. An adult human has 206 bones, while a child, infant, okay, it has around 300. facial bones. Cranium is this part, the upper part of the head where the brain is located. So the cranium supports the it protects the internal organ, that is the brain. It protects the internal organ, and cranium consists of seven bones. Okay, while facial bones are 14 in number. Okay, I will show you the image so that you can easily understand it. So this is the cranium, children. Okay, so this is the cranium, children. This is complete skull, and this upper part is the cranium. Okay, so you can see. Okay, so this is the upper part, that is the cranium, and you can see there are lot of like zigzag lines, correct? So these are the bones which are fused in the when they are the baby stage. So these bones will be freely moving. Okay, so there will be lot of space as it grows, the baby grows into the adult, these bones fuse, and there are seven bones which will be fused here, and these bones cannot be moved. Okay, so they are called fixed joints. We will study about them also. Now these are the facial bones. Okay, and you can see there are sockets here where the eyeballs can be fixed here, correct? And these are the nasal bones present here, and there are the sockets even for the tooth. Okay. Okay, children, next coming to the rib cage. So the rib cage is the chest part of our body. Okay, so the rib cage consists of here the complete rib cage is made up of the backbone, ribs, as well as the breastbone, also called as sternum. Breastbone is called as sternum. So there are 12 pairs of ribs, children. There are 12 pairs of ribs. In that, only the 10 pairs of ribs will be attached both to the sternum as well as the backbone. Only then, see, the ribs will be present here and it will be attached from the sternum towards to the backbone. Only then it can form a cage-like structure. Then only 10 pairs of ribs are attached both to the sternum as well as the backbone. The last two pairs of ribs are attached only to the backbone. So they are called as floating ribs. Most of you have studied about this, correct? The last year, this is just a kind of brush up for you. So the last two pairs are called floating ribs because they are only attached to the backbone, not to the sternum. Okay, children? So total there are 12 pairs of ribs here. And a rib cage is completely made up of sternum, the ribs, and the backbone. Okay. Now coming to the backbone. Okay, the third one in your axial skeleton. Backbone is made up of small bones called as vertebrae, and they are 33 in number. So these backbone, children, you might feel that the backbone is a straight one long bone. No, it is completely wrong. Backbone is backbone is made up of small vertebrae. They are 33 in number. 33 bones totally are there. So the backbone will be like this kind of shape. Okay. So it is not straight. It is a curved shape. And this helps to bend, move like this. Okay. Turn our waist because of this. The curvation in the backbone. Now I'll show you the backbone. So this is the image of the backbone, and backbone is also called as vertebral column. Okay, because the bones of this backbone are called as vertebrae, and so it has got the name as vertebral column. See how these bones are raised. This is from the neck region, starting from the neck. And here is the curve, and here is the hip region. It will end to the hip region, and there are the bones will be of various size. You can come to know from this only, correct? And see children, you can also feel your back spine of your backbone. I'll show you one image. Okay, so this is one kind of backbone. Okay, which is present in the you can say the backside of your chest, that is the ribs where it is attached. So these are the places where the ribs will get attached to the backbone, and this is the spine. Okay, spine, which you can feel when you touch your back. So this you can feel when you touch your back, and here you can see a small the hole kind of thing, where the spinal cord will pass inside this vertebral column. From here, you have studied about spinal cord, right? So spinal cord, starting from this, the medulla, it will come and extend towards the hip region. Okay, so how? Because from this structure, this will enter, spinal cord will enter this ring like structure. Okay, that means the backbone also protects the spinal cord. Okay,
between the backbone vertebrae, between each vertebrae there will be a cartilage substance. Okay, cartilage present, which is a rubber like substance, which helps in, like, when two bones will sit on each other, correct? And the movement, during the movement, the bones will rub against each other. So when it is rubbing, the bone to bone, if it rubs, then it will hurt a lot. Also, the bone will get degraded slowly. That is why the cartilage, that is a soft rubber-like substance, will be present between the vertebrae. Also, in our body, children, have you observed, like, in any of your family members or yourself, you must have fallen down and have taken an x-ray of your body. So what you can see in that x-ray, children, why does the doctor ask you to take an x-ray? So that he can view your bones, whether the bone has got damaged somewhere and that's why it is paining to you, correct? So you can observe your structure of your bone through an x-ray machine, children. Okay? And each, yes. So how many bones are there? Even you can find out that. So if you see your hand here, your arm, the lower arm, you might think it is made up of one single bone. No, children, it is not made up of one single bone. There are two bones here. We will study about that now. Okay? Now coming to the four limbs, children. So four limbs are our arms. Okay, arms. So in your arm, that is your hand region, we usually call it as hand, our hand in just a normal language. So here the four limbs divided into three parts: upper arm, lower arm and hand. So upper arm is from your shoulder region till your elbow. Okay, from upper region, shoulder region till your elbow. And lower arm is from your elbow, starting from your elbow till your wrist. okay, and hand is this part. This part is called as hand, the dorsal and the lateral side. Okay, so now upper arm, it is attached to the axial skeleton with the help of the shoulder bone and collar bone. Your collar bone, you can touch and see here where the collar of the where you can find the collar of your shirts. Okay, this part you can find the collar bone. It will be clearly visible, or sometimes you have to just press a bit. So the upper arm is made up of humerus, one long bone called as humerus, while this lower arm is made up of two bones, that is radius and ulna. Okay, and our hand are made up of wrist bones. See children, this is the wrist part, correct? So it is made up of wrist bones. Then you can say the wrist bones are also called as carpals. Then comes the phalanges, that is the bones of your fingers. Okay, so the upper arm is made up of humerus, lower arm is made up of radius and ulna. And this humerus and radius and ulna meet at the elbow. Then hand is made up of wrist bones. There are several wrist bones, children, called as carpals. And then again, this is the wrist bone. This part is the metacarpals. We call them as metacarpals. And the finger bones we call as phalanges. You can touch and see each bone of your finger. You can feel that they are not one single bone. They are not one single bone, children. Next, coming to the hind limbs. Okay? Hind limbs, again, same like four limbs. You have upper, lower and leg. So here upper is made up of one long bone called as femur. Femur is the longest bone in our body. Then the lower limb is made up of tibia and fibula. Tibia and fibula. Again, the femur and tibia fibula meet at your knee. How we have elbow in hand, in case of legs we have knee. And the leg part is made up of the ankle bones, okay, called as tarsals, T-A-R-S-A-L-S, and here carpals, tarsals. Then again phalanges. Okay, the finger, the toes of the foot, what we call as phalanges. So hope you have understood this. And the hind limbs, children, the femur is attached to the axial skeleton at the hip region, the hip bone. There is a big hip bone which has a socket like structure for this femur to attach, and that is how the hind limbs are attached to the axial skeleton. So four limbs and hind limbs are attached to the axial skeleton by the help of pectoral and pelvic girdle. Pectoral and pelvic girdle. Okay, so this is what all about now for this session. Next session we will learn about the joints. Okay, thank you.